Dear Jewel, I left you with a few things to always hold on to. Loyalty, elusiveness, and brute force. If you remember these lessons, you will survive. If anyone can, it's you. Love you always. Dad.
Hey gang, it's Larry here, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome! I'm here with the legendary...
Legendary, wow.
Joe Staten. We are here to show off the first 20 minutes of ReCore. Very excited about that. Now, Joe and I are here. We're sitting in the streaming room. We're at Microsoft headquarters in Seattle. And
it's intimate. I'd call it intimate.
Yeah, it's very intimate. For those of you that know streaming, you have to be in really close, and it feels awkward, and frankly, it is. But today we're going to show off... Well, actually, Joe, why don't you tell us what we're gonna see today?
Sure. So, like you said, this is the first 20-ish minutes of the game. Or you know what? We can make it as long as you want, Larry.
As long as you guys want in the chat room, right?
That's right. That's right. But it's basically the very beginning of the game. So, at this point in the story, really nothing has happened except you might know a little bit about the backstory of the game.
Yep.
The main character, Jewel Adams, has come to this planet, Far Eden. Mm-hmm. The whole goal was to make this a new home for mankind. So, we were going to terraform the planet. The humans, the colonists, were going to sleep for a couple hundred years, and while they slept, their robots, the core bots, were meant to make terraforming devices.
Right, go off and do the work.
That's right, turn this into a garden world. Well, you can see, however, when Jewel wakes up, which is going to happen in just a second here, nothing has gone according to plan. The terraforming machines have failed, Far Eden is still a desert, all the humans are missing, most of the core bots have gone crazy, except for Jewel's friendly companion there, who you can see wandering around. Mac, the blue core dog. So that's really, you know, all players really know when they start the game, and we try to keep things a little mysterious at the beginning of this game.
All right, so I want to point out what we are doing is we are starting right at the top. This is just after the game loads. Now, for ease of streaming, we're playing on PC.
Right.
This is the PC version. It's available on Xbox One as well. This is a Play Anywhere title.
That's correct. So one purchase on one platform will get you the game on the other platform too.
And because it's a Play Anywhere title, in this case, that means also your save will go back and forth. So if you're playing at home in your console and you're on the road and you want to pull it up on your PC and there's your save right there.
Yep, absolutely. And you know, like in my household, if the kids are on the TV and or on the PC, we often are kicking each other off the devices, and it's nice to have that feature. It's actually way more handy than I thought it was going to be.
All right, well, why don't we press A to start, shall we?
Why don't you press A?
I'm going to press A. So here we go. We are starting ReCore.
So good.
You can see in the lower left-hand corner, this is apparently a dev build, so we're setting it up.
Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah,
so this is really right off the top.
You know, we'll keep subtitles on in case people just want to follow along if you and I are yakking. Getting the full, like, fresh-out-of-the-box experience here.
When we started, I told you, I said, I want to be right off the top, just like as if we're you know, just like what people are going to experience next week. The game comes out next week.
Game comes out starting from the 13th in North America, and then, the 15th in Japan, and the 16th in Europe, I believe.
So all week next week is ReCore week.
That's right.
All right, we are at the planet Far Eden, as you heard Joe talk about just a little bit earlier. It's currently 5 minutes after the hour. We're going to be streaming for the next, 45 minutes or an hour. We'll see how it goes.
Mm-hmm.
Until our voices give in. So we're very excited here.
I'll let this just play. Let them soak this in.
I want you guys at home to really just enjoy this for yourself.
Far Eden. It wasn't supposed to be like this.
Go on, Mac. It's over there.
But if anyone can set things right, Jewel, I knew it would be you.
Okay. We're looking for a power source. It's the only way we're going to get our crawler back online. Do you have the scent, Mac?
All right, Mac's talking to you.
All right, and you can just the observant viewer would have seen one of the first little Easter eggs in the game. Every time one of the core bots speaks to you, where'd Mac go? He's around here somewhere. They speak their own language, this language called Digimote. And so even in the subtitles, we're not translating those for you. They show up in little Digimote symbols. So people who are really curious will have to translate.
Okay.
Have to translate
to see what they're saying.
What they said. Yep.
Now, I want to talk to you a little bit about the core gameplay.
Yes.
We just really need to stop and talk about the team that worked on this and your creative team.
Absolutely,
so
absolutely.
Let's talk about them.
So as I run forward a little bit, here as Jewel ties her shoelace. so this is the brainchild of Keiji Inafune of Mega Man fame, of course, other great games as well, and the core leads who made the Metroid Prime games, who formed a studio called Armature. So together, Armature and Keiji Inafune's studio called Concept brought this great pitch for a new IP to us, and that's what ReCore is. It's a classic Mega Man Metroid style game with some new modern systems layered on top.
Now I want to talk about that because we hear everybody say Mega Man Metroid style, but there's actually some people that are afraid to ask, well, what does that mean? So why don't you explain that a little bit?
Yeah, sure.
I mean, I hate to get basic, but I think it's really good for people to know.
No, that's a great question. So if you want to think about Mega Man, the real fun of that game was the fast, fun platforming and combat as well. And Mega Man, you were unlocking abilities over time. Those abilities made you more effective against specific bosses, et cetera, et cetera. Mega Man also had hidden areas in the game that you would come back to later once you had additional abilities. ReCore has that same sort of spirit. It's about improving, in this case, your core bots over time, making them stronger and stronger. And ReCore is what we call a semi-open world game. So at the end of the demo, I'll show you one of those sort of open world little hub areas. And I think players will really begin to see, wow, you know, this game is actually pretty big. Like, there's a lot to explore and fun places to poke your nose into. So that's the way I at least think about it, the Mega Man heritage.
I just want to make sure we all have a baseline. Everybody in the chat room that's watching us on Beam and Twitch or maybe out there on Twitter or wherever that they're aware of this. So we saw a double jump.
So you have the Jewel has got a couple abilities here. She has the ability to double jump. And some little guys flew over her head. You can double jump. You can have a little bit of air time, so you can hang a little bit. Jewel also has a dash ability here. You can see her scribing through the sand.
Oh, fine.
And you can chain those together. So you can double jump, dash. Or if you want, you can dash, double jump, and then dash again. You can see that Jewel's got little rocket boosters on her shoes and her back.
Yep.
These will, basically, you only have a limited amount of that power. It recharges over time. So you can do a couple little changes of these moves, but you can't do it, you know, forever.
Sure.
You can see that ReCore is not like, you know, Gears of War, for example. It's not really a cover-based game. So in combat, you'll see as I engage this first group of enemies, really to stay safe, I need to dash and jump. And be very, very fast and fluid.
So you really need to be mobile and keep moving during combat.
Exactly. So here are these little basic enemies come in, these things called core bites.
Hold left to lock on and right trigger to fire.
That's right. So you asked about the heritage of the game. That's very Metroid-ish, that sort of lock-on, lock-on strafe system. And just by flicking the right thumbstick, I can switch between different enemies. So as long as we're talking about my weapons, Jewel has got an energy rifle here. Thanks for shouldering that for us, Jewel.
Thank you.
This energy rifle, over time, you'll unlock additional ammo types for it on the D-pad. So right now, I've just got this neutral white ammo, which
we've
is
all
down.
Seen that, and you're going to be filling that out as the game progresses.
Exactly. And, you know, I just to call this out, because it's something that I really love about this game, is its accessibility. So ReCore is a color-matching game. They're colored enemies. You want to match your ammo type to those enemies. Well, if you're colorblind,
that's hard.
That's hard, right? Yeah. So if you just notice, it's a very small detail, but something I think the whole team is really proud of is there's this little hash mark on the down, the sort of upside down chevron there.
Yeah, that's a little pointing down.
Right. So you'll see maybe in this demo, I don't know if we'll see any pure white enemies, but basically every enemy on their health bar will have a little chevron pointing one direction on the D-pad. So if you're fighting, I think red is to the left. Those all red enemies will have a little call out that'll let you know, even if you're colorblind, I should be using red.
So
red
in addition
ammo.
To color, we also have these small symbols that'll kind of help those that are colorblind.
Right.
That's great.
Yeah, absolutely. And that combined with subtitles, that's something I really appreciate about this game.
Looks like
okay, so Jewel's got this energy rifle. You lock on with left trigger, fire with right, and you switch your ammo with the D-pad.
I also want to point out that the UI is really, I mean, certainly we have the tips in the upper right-hand corner of our current objective, but it's quite clean. We see health in the upper left.
Yep, absolutely. You can see the UI, of course, will go away. You have your, just because it's the tutorial mission, this is sort of a persistent, you know, quest message up there. But yeah, we really wanted to keep the UI off screen as much as possible and just show off the the real beauty of this barren landscape.
Well, I love that because then you can go in here and kind of set up the perfect screenshot for your background on your console or your PC. You know, you can just go there and use the beauty of the game and just take a couple of screenshots.
Yep, absolutely, absolutely. So let's keep on fighting up here. Jewel's exploring.
Keep on keeping on.
She's looking for this strange energy source. Now, she wants to use this to power up her crawler, her habitat.
Right.
Okay, so you see here I'm locked on these guys. I can swap back and forth between them. So you can see here, when I'm firing, your ammo is energy ammo, and it recharges over time. If I just hold down on the trigger here...
You're going to drain it.
I'll drain it, and my shots will become progressively less and less accurate. So really, if you can see here now, the spread is quite wide. So it really pays to pulse your ammo.
Yep.
And of course, once you get different ammo types, switch it. Now, the other thing her energy rifle has is an overcharge shot. So if I hold down my right bumper... it'll build up to a powerful shot. This doesn't have tracking, so you really need to aim it a little bit before
you
release.
So you lose the tracking, but it's
correct.
But it's a little more powerful.
Yep, so then they'll just fire wherever you were last aiming.
Yep.
And of course, you have variants of this for all the different ammo ammo types. And this is good at taking down groups of enemies, like those little flying mines I was fighting earlier, or taking down shields of the bigger enemies.
So we have a little indicator, a little waypoint. We see the green in the upper screen that's kind of leading her where to go. Looks like we need to go somewhere up there.
That's right. So this is your first little tutorial about platforming in the game.
Okay.
And ReCore really is this nice mix of combat and platforming.
Now, we see we've got Mac here. What is his role in the game? We're certainly doing all the combat. What's he going to be doing?
Great question.
Or she.
You know, Mac is a boy. It's a little bit like Snow White and the Seven Dwarves. All the little cores are male. They have male names, rugged male names like Mac and Seth and Duncan.
Right.
You know? So good.
But how will we use Mac and Seth and Duncan and Chad and the rest of them as the grain progresses?
Chad, yeah, that's good. We'll have to put that in the file cabinet for next time. So, all right, good, great question. So Mac, in just a little bit, you'll see his combat abilities.
Okay.
Basically, the core bots are your second weapon beyond your energy rifle. So when I'm locked onto an enemy, I can use Mac and trigger what's called his lethal attack. Let me get up to an enemy here that I can sort of show you how that works.
It's a long way down.
Another cool vista in the world.
Mm-hmm.
So if I were to lock onto one of these enemies here, and these guys aren't going to attack me, they're poor little helpless core bites in the world, you can see Mac, his health bar underneath Jewel, he hasn't unlocked this yet because it's going to come in the tutorial in just a sec, but he will have these little pips, a little electricity bolts above his health bar that will indicate how many special attacks he can do. So if I'm locked onto an enemy and I hold down the Y button, Mac will dash out and do this stunning charge electricity attack.
Okay.
And each core is different. The blue core is all about electricity. Each has their own personality. So Mac is like the cheerful, sparky, happy core.
Yeah.
So all his attacks are sparky and electrical and
happy.
Stunning. Exactly. And so you'll see in the dog frame, his attack, the blue core, his attack is this dash, this energy dash. But if I were to take Mac, the blue core, and put him into a different frame, like the spider, his charge attack would be different. It would be a ranged standoff laser beam stunning attack. So now we're getting into like the sort of deep gameplay systems. But we'll see Mac's first attack in just a little bit here.
All right.
But first of all, we have to figure out how to open up this door.
Yeah. Puzzle.
Seems to be missing something, Larry.
It does.
Some sort of plug device.
We must insert, perhaps even turn.
Yes. Now, of course, if this were another kind of game, you might just find an actual plug. Yeah. But no, in ReCore, everything has got a little personality.
Wait a minute.
A little creature.
Mac
so here,
apparently has discovered something.
That's
and
right.
He's barking.
This cute little, we call a cell bot, this little plug. So we're going to coax him over here to this socket where he belongs.
And he's going to pop himself in.
He likes it. He's going to pop in.
There he spins around.
Look how happy he is.
In you go.
In you go.
All right.
Now, just a small example for me about the sort of charm and anime and manga roots of this game. That Keiji Inafune really, I think, was passionate about making sure we kept
on,
in the game.
Way.
I think it's just this fun little color and charm that really sets this game apart, which is nice.
Yeah, I mean, this is beautiful looking so far. I know we're right at the beginning. All right,
here's another core bite.
Mac,
okay. And you can see these are things that are little grabbers. And look, Mac just got grabbed by one of them.
What?
Yep.
Where's he
going? He's taking Mac away. Larry, where's he gonna go?
That's not part of the plan.
No, it's
not. Come back, Mac. Come back.
So, yeah, each of these core bites, they're little tiny enemies, the smaller enemies in the world. Actually, some of them are pretty big, but they're sort of like they have one really cool gameplay hook. Like the grabbers grab your core bots and take them away. So there are core bites like that in the game, and then there are core bots, enemy dogs and tanks and spiders, and we'll meet some of those in a little bit.
What do we have going on with the heart?
Oh, so that tells you that Mac is down. He's down somewhere. He's been injured, and I have to find him and revive him. So okay. During combat, your core bots can actually be knocked out.
Okay.
All right, so here's Jewel off to find where Mac is.
Uh-oh.
There's another example of a little group of core bites.
Yes.
They form these little lattices or nets throughout the game. Now, I can, if I want, sort of take them out one by one, but that's not super efficient because they'll just recharge over time and build the net again. So here's a good use of the overcharge shot. If I build up an overcharge shot and let it fly,
boom,
I'll take all those guys out.
There you go.
Now, this is just training us on how to dash. So I'll just dash through this gate. Oh, I didn't do it!
Or not.
Man, it's not like I haven't played this game or something. All right, here we go. Oh, come on!
That's how you can tell it's live, gang.
There we go. It's going to be great. Right here. Oh, yeah.
There we go. Oh!
Larry, believe. Believe, Larry. Believe it's going
to
be great.
Just want to be clear. I don't have the controller. Okay? I do not have the controller.
Oh, wait a sec. Hold on. Wait a sec. B while moving to dash. Okay, I believe. This is the time.
Okay.
No.
This is fascinating.
Okay. There we... Oh! Almost.
This is fascinating. Hold on.
We're not getting through.
All right, hold on. Wait a minute.
Darn it,
Chad. I seriously have played this tutorial about a million times.
I know you have.
So I don't know what the dealio is here.
We're going to... We are not able to get through here. This is going to be a little bit of a challenge.
This is fascinating.
We may have to take a quick break and have you guys watch a trailer
No. We're gonna troubleshoot this, Larry.
Okay, okay,
there we go. I just needed to do it sooner.
Sooner. Well done.
Well, now I know how to do dash. That's the good of a tutorial.
That's right. As any good gamer.
See, they're right there. Where was that major pest place that start dashing earlier? Right, that's right. If I just looked at this chat log, I would have been fine. All right. So here we are. Okay, so we're still looking for Mac.
Mac, and that. So now we have another problem. Whoa.
So this is a little teaching you how to do, maybe a double jump and a dash to the other side.
Good job. There we go.
See, there I nailed that one.
Okay, we got another one. I've got something else going.
No, it's
going
to be great. Okay, so this is teaching you about Jewel's third weapon, tool, really. She's got on her wrist this extractor. So this is used for opening doors like this. I lock onto them with left trigger. I fire it with the right stick. I can pull.
Okay.
But it's a little fishing game here. So if you see, if I pull too much or too early, the cord will get red and can turn to white, and then my extractor will disengage. So I'm pulling with my right stick and sort of feathering it.
Okay.
Now, you're not just going to be pulling doorknobs. You're going to be pulling cores out of enemy core bots, which I'll show you in a little bit. So that's really what the extractor is for, is yanking out cores.
Yep.
But before we get to that...
Oh, no!
Here he is.
What happened here?
He needs to be revived, Larry. Here, you revive
him. Press X to revive.
It'll make you feel better.
I'm not paying my respects. I'm reviving.
There you go.
Uh-oh. Mac apparently is happy.
He's back. Okay. He's back.
We're not going to find many.
Does he want to tell us what happened, or is he just going to...
I think he's got a little bit of amnesia going on.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So here we are. Another little room. Oh, all right. Enemies. So these are enemy core bots. Oh, I have an instant extract, actually.
Now, what is that?
So that's a special that you get every once in a while. You can save up that special instant extract. But here, I'm locked on. I'm going to press down the right thumbstick. And I don't even have to do the tug-of-war thing. I just instantly yank out his core.
So it's like an insta-kill.
Exactly. So you'll see here, I have the option to extract if he died. Now, this is a little frenetic. You'll see that I'm dashing, jumping to stay out of the way of these enemy attacks, but I want you to pay attention to the combo meter.
Okay.
This is something not a lot of people realize is
the
in the game.
Combo meter's located
up there. You can see now
top,
I have a combo of two.
Right?
This builds up every time I break down one of the enemy's layers of health. You can see they've got little black triangles on their health bars.
Yep.
If I were to reduce it past these white triangles, I'd get an additional combo, and that raises how much damage I do.
I see. So it's a multiplier.
Exactly. You want to build up your combo as much as possible, and then you'll just tear through enemies really quickly.
And here we go. It feels like a little mini boss area.
Exactly. So this little cutscene is going to teach you about Mac's lethal dash attack. He's got this ability.
Here we go.
When you press Y, to just pound through enemies. So, right.
All right. Let's read this together, shall we?
Sure. Why don't you read it out loud?
Lethal
nice
commands.
Speed.
Jewel can command her core bots to use powerful lethal abilities. Press Y while targeting an enemy to use Mac's dash ability.
Exactly. And I see in the chat, there's some people asking about, well, just joking about 100 combo. No 100 combo, but you can build up your combo, I believe, to once you get it to 10,
right?
You earn an instant extract.
All right.
So it really pays to build up your combo, especially in large groups of powerful enemies, to keep that combo number high, and it decays over time and will, you know, default back to zero.
Good.
You also can build up your combo by destroying some of the smaller enemies, those core bites, those little floating mines and mm-hmm. other things. So often you'll go up against a big, tough enemy. He'll be surrounded by smaller ones. A good tactic is to pick off those smaller enemies right. first, build up your combo meter, and then go after the juicy center, as it were.
Now, before you hit A to continue, I want to point in the upper left-hand corner. It looks like Max got some additional items on his health bar.
Exactly. So this is the little energy pip that I talked about earlier.
Yep.
This tells you that Mac has one lethal attack, which I will launch right now. So I'll lock onto one of these enemies, press Y, and Mac will bounce off of him and almost brought him down to his first little pip of...
And I can see it's recharging up there.
That's right. It's on a cooldown. And I will, if I take this guy down below his white triangles, that means he's now vulnerable to an extraction. Now, I don't have instant extract, so I need to be a little careful here. I'm pulling back and forth.
Right, that's a little mini game.
This little mini game.
Yep.
Yank out his port. Okay. Let me take out this other guy, and I'll talk a little bit about why you would want to take out a core versus, as I'm going to do right here, use another lethal for Mac, break this guy down into pieces.
Oh.
Okay, more dudes.
Yeah, more dudes.
So now if you people were watching the numbers, they would see that I'm not as effective, or Mac is not as effective against these guys. Hold on, let me get his lethal going. I'll instant extract him. Oop. Get Mac's lethal going here. He's not as powerful against the red enemies. Okay. He's really best at blue.
So once again, talking to that matching, his core is blue.
Exactly.
So we're talking about all the color matching.
Exactly. Okay. So let's see, Mac's still on his cooldown. So I'll just take these guys out with the energy rifle. I'll use
now, is Mac able to do
shot.
Any additional help while he's cooling down here?
So he has his own AI. He'll okay. go and attack these guys just on his own. You'll see he causes damage, which will help me out. But really, you want to use his lethal like this.
Right.
And really take this guy down. Okay. Extract here.
And this feels classic classic combat. You know, we can see all the... We can see the health bar, we can see how much damage we're doing. It's very, very, very straightforward.
Absolutely, absolutely. And it's really this fast-paced, fun, frenetic, very... You know, we're talking a little bit, so I'm not being as efficient with my gameplay as I should be.
No.
But yes, it's very fast, very fluid, very fun, and very tactical. You know, really, really... Once you unlock all the ammo and you get into encounters with multiple different core enemy colors and mm-hmm. lots of different smaller enemies, you're really thinking, well, how do I... be most efficient with switching my core bots, switching my ammo, all those things.
Now, is there a inventory screen? Is there a leveling up screen?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Can we take a look at that?
There is. I don't know if it's unlocked currently. Oh, it is. Okay. So here you can see in our inventory the cores that we've collected.
Okay.
Now, we probably won't get too deep into this in this particular go-through, but you can see here under the extracted red core, it says can be converted into red fusion in the crawler.
So I need to bring them back.
Right. So if you take these cores back into the crawler, mm-hmm. it will build up. You see those little starburst symbols mm-hmm. right above where I am, the blue and the yellow and the red? That's my fusion energy. I can take that energy and I can combine it into my friendly cores. Why would I want to do that?
Why would you want to do that?
Mac, you could see his lethals, for example, were on a cooldown. If I were to fuse energy into his core, I would be able to reduce that cooldown, for example. I could also make his energy attack more powerful. I can, by using this fusion energy that I get from enemies, I can make my own cores more powerful through the crafting system.
I see. So there's a crafting. Can we go back to that other screen?
Yes, absolutely. There's no crafting here. You would have to go back to the crawler and do it.
Sure.
But you can see here it lists, whoops.
Those are the options.
Those are my options.
Always a sexy screen.
Who's in my crew?
Yep.
And you can see here the stats for Mac, and this is what I was talking about before, the attack stat and defense and energy.
Yep.
If I were to fuse blue energy, blue core energy from enemies into Mac, the blue core, I would raise his energy level, which would reduce his cooldown for his lethals. So that's really the purpose of yanking out enemy cores, is to improve your own cores.
It says right stick details, so if you click in on the right stick.
Right stick details.
There we go. Oh, nice.
Yep, so you'll see a little bit more about Mac.
Yep.
Here it currently shows his lethal recharge time. Again, if I were to increase his energy, that would go down. Reboot time is the amount of time it takes for him to come back after being knocked out. So if he were knocked out in combat, they will, over time, slowly recharge, and I can increase that or decrease that reboot time as well. So I think right off the bat, people who are watching the stream can see, hopefully, oh wow, like I see the Mega Man and Metroid, but I had no idea that it was also like an RPG, that there were these RPG systems layered on it too. And that, I think, for me, is the real long-term fun of this game, is really taking your core bots and upgrading them, really maxing out your fun little friends that you find in the game.
Now, you can have Mac and the other ones with you as well, right?
Absolutely right. Now, we won't get another one of the core bots in this demo, but you can have up to two core bots in your party at a time.
Okay.
And you'll bring them on and off the battlefield by pressing the left bumper. You'll swap between them.
Got it.
Okay, so that's what the importance of cores. And I'll talk about how you upgrade frames in just a little bit. But first, you asked earlier, hey, is there anything else Mac can do?
Mm-hmm.
In combat, he's got his lethal attacks. Out of combat, each frame has a special ability. And Mac's, as you can see on screen here, is to have him search. So if I hold down X, Mac will search the immediate area.
That radius, I see.
Yeah, you can see he's in search mode.
Yep.
And he will find...
Oh.
What is he going to find?
Boop.
All right, another one of these little cell bots. And this happy little fellow will go over here and unlock this door. And throughout the world, you will see little things like this out in the sand. And whenever you see one of these, it's worth bringing Mac, having him hunt. I don't think there's anything underneath this one. I think that was just another place where the cell bot could come from.
Right.
But usually we hide really cool things here, like health boosters that will permanently increase Jewel's health, and really sort of a really useful things. So that's Mac's special ability.
So it's worth it to kind of take a moment before you go into combat or after you clean up an area. Just kind of search around, because things may not be visible immediately, and that's why you need your...
That's absolutely right.
Do you call them a canine?
His actual name of his frame, I believe, if you look here on the crew tab, is Mac is in a... Oh, it doesn't say it here, but yes, he's in a
K-9
frame.
K-9 frame.
Yep.
All right,
should we continue our adventure?
Please.
All right, here we go.
Let's see what the chat room thinks. We have both the Beam and Twitch chats open here, so we're kind of reading your comments, the nice ones.
Nice.
Thank you guys for joining us. We're sitting here with Joe Staten. We're taking a look at ReCore. If you're just tuning in, we're taking a look at ReCore, which comes out next week. It's an Xbox Play Anywhere title. Buy it on the console, get the PC game at no extra cost, or vice versa. So very excited about that. It's available for pre-order. And Joe is walking us through about the first 20 minutes or so of the game. He's taking our time. We're seeing what the mechanics look like. Hopefully you're enjoying that. All right.
So there was just another little enemy, another core bite. Oh, another segment there. A core bite caterpillar. Now, as you might suspect, they come in small sizes and very large caterpillars that you might end up fighting out in the world. But like any good caterpillar, they break into pieces when you shoot the middle of them.
I wonder if it's affecting the other bots.
All right, we're headed our way to the objective.
Yep, still looking for this strange energy source, a power source. Uh-oh.
We know what to do here.
You know what we're going to do is this time we're going to use Mac against this little lattice. I can just use his lethal attack.
Okay.
And he'll take him out. Ooh, see, just to show I know how to use air dash, I'm going to dash.
Yes, I was going to say, that was impressive.
Yeah, I'm still pretty embarrassed about that whole thing earlier.
Extractor should work on this door, just like before.
Another extractor door here. Yep. Just training players on how to use it.
So yeah, this is RPG meets platforming meets... Okay, here we go.
All right, so this enemy is a little tougher. Ouch. He has got a shield on him, and here we're just telling you, in case you hadn't done it before, hey, charge shot is really good at taking down shields. So you can see sort of like a little overlay on his health bar. If I charge up my charge shot and let it go, I'll take down his shield.
And it's also important to point out, he's blue.
He's blue, so Mac.
Mac can do some damage.
So we'll see how much damage Mac does. So pretty good pop there. Now I'm below the white triangle, so it tells me I can extract. So let's see if this guy's a little tougher on the extract. Yeah, so he's definitely tugging a lot more.
Right.
He's a little higher level core. You see it almost went to white there. Actually, I was going to let it break.
There you go.
Got his core.
So now you have the core, and you give the core, and you put it in your pocket.
Your magical pocket that can hold anything
right.
and everything forever.
Your large pockets.
Right. All right, so here we go. We're almost at the end of this little part of the demo. We're getting close.
Is that really Shannon in the chat?
Uh-oh, we better clean it up if Shannon's in the chat.
I was going to say.
Phil jumps in. You and I better sit up straight in our chairs a little bit, straighten our ties. Okay. So Jewel is looking for this power source, and indeed she has finally found it. So we're going to jump down into this area. I'm sure nothing's going to go wrong when we do this.
No, I mean, let's
pull this thing out. Should be
it's
fine.
A trap! All right, so we're playing a little bit of ReCore.
Dang it.
Really interesting character modeling we've got with her, with both of them, actually.
Absolutely.
In fact, I've got a little cosplay to do here.
Oh, you want to wear the hat? Okay, well, I want to wear the hat later on. It's going to be good.
Let's see how that goes. I don't know if that's going
to
work.
You know, when we get out in the sandstorm, though, you do need to put the goggles
on. Yeah,
I
do.
That's really going to set the whole look off. Nice!
There we go. Do this the hard way.
All right, so here's your first chance against a mini-boss or sub-boss character.
Okay.
This character called Iron Fang.
Okay.
Spider character. You can see he's different, though, because he switches colors.
Uh-oh.
And here you can see some of that, those different attacks depending on the core. So when Iron Fang is in a red core configuration, he's got this flame dash that he'll do. If I reduce his health a little bit, here's Mac. Mac's down. I better pay attention to that.
Yeah.
Mac is down. You can see he's recharging, but I can't use his lethal attack now, so I'm just stuck on my own.
Now, you said he goes from red to blue, and he's at white
right
now.
So now he's at white, which is great, because my white ammo is going to be really effective against him, so Mac's just about to wake up here.
Getting just showing off the fact that lower left, that D-pad is going to show you where your different color and symbols.
So now Iron Fang, whoa, is a...
So now when he's blue, you can have Mac attack him for massive damage.
Correct. So, yes, he's a little bit more powerful, so maybe not massive, but I'll pop both Mac's lethal attacks. And you can see here, Iron Fang has got this stunning beam that I need to dash
over.
Yep. And indeed, that's what Mac's attack would be if he were in the spider frame. He would use that same blue beam that Iron Fang is using.
Now again, the black hash marks and the white hash marks in the health bar. Explain those again to us.
Right, so he's got different shield or health layers here.
You can see them right there.
Right, if I get him down below this white one, which is what I'm trying to do, we're going to rip out his core.
I see.
Now, its core is special. It's like this weird rainbow core.
Well, yeah, because he's got multicolors.
That's right, the strange power source that Jewel was tracking. So here, we'll grab him again with a little...
We're almost there.
Almost there, lethal
attack.
Almost
there. There it is.
There we go.
Extract. Bullet. Come on, Joe.
Be a little more careful with this guy.
Yeah, he's not going to give it up easy.
He's not
giving it up easy. There she goes.
Gotcha.
Ooh, look at that. It's a disco core.
They're not called disco cores, Larry. But you know what? For today, sure, why not?
Why not?
Disco core. Well, indeed, Jewel doesn't know. She has no idea what this thing is. It might as well be a disco core to her because she's never seen these things.
Right. So what is this thing? It's mysterious.
It's mysterious. I don't want to spoil the story, but these cores not only have this interesting combat property of switching colors, but they're important to the whole Far Eden colony.
Sure.
Not only can they serve as a power source for Jewel's crawler, her habitat, but they also power up other Far Eden systems too. Some of the terraforming machines and other things that I won't spoil. But they act a little bit like the keys to the world. So now that I have this core, these big security doors that wouldn't open up before, will open up when I get close.
I want to say hello to everybody in the stream on Beam and Twitch. Thank you guys for joining us. I'm here with Joe State. We're showing off the first little bit of ReCore, which comes out on Xbox next week. This is a Play Anywhere title. That means you buy it on Xbox, you get it on your PC at no extra charge. Or you buy it on PC and you get it on Xbox for no extra charge. Great thing about that is that the game save goes to the cloud and can be pulled down on either platform. So this is a really interesting Metroid style platformer game. There's a lot going on here. There's RPG elements, there's platformer.
Yep.
This is busy. There's a lot here.
Now this is where the demo, we go into the land of unscripted, Larry.
Okay.
We could do whatever we want here.
Oh.
But the first thing I wanted to show is people often ask, hey, like how long is ReCore? How big of a game is this? It's $40.
Right.
Well, the interesting thing is I would say I have played this game many, many times.
Yep.
And I just replayed it this past week. And it took me about 15 hours to complete the story, like the Golden Path story.
Yep.
Beyond that, there were still tons of dungeons I hadn't gotten into, other things to collect, and I don't think we really want to put a cap on like how much you could really play, but it is a nice big campaign. This is not a 4-hour game. This is this is much more than that.
Right.
You can see here it's also a pretty big world too. ReCore is not an open world game like a Red Dead, like a Massive or a Skyrim, but it does have these very large open world like hub areas that you can explore. I'll just go a little bit deeper into this area. You can see off in the distance Jewel's crawler, Jewel's sand crawler.
Yeah.
And if I were to bring up the map now,
home
you can sort of start to get a sense for how big this area is that Jewel is in. This little
and there's many other, other areas as well.
That's right. So this is the smallest of our open world areas, the smallest of our overworlds. And I won't, you know, spoil things too much by moving the map around, but they get progressively bigger and bigger. So as you look out on this open world, just understand, hey, this is actually the smallest of these. Hidden in this place are not just enemies to fight. You can see some sort of wandering beasts that are wandering characters in ReCore. Jewel's crawler, where she does her crafting, is over there, which we probably won't go into today. But there are other things hidden around. It's a little bit far away, but I know, having played through this before, that there's actually a dungeon entrance hidden up on that rocky bluff. I also know that up on this little rocky pillar, there's a weird rock formation. Actually, let me go over there and check it out.
Now, what is this right here?
So, yes, this is a piece of loot. So if I pick it up, I will get some worn pistons, which will show up in my inventory.
That I can use for crafting later on.
Correct. Yep. Tells you where they drop from. And this is what I would use to build most likely a spider part for the spider frame. It's a blueprint system, so I need to find blueprints in the world first, and then I'm able to make from those blueprints actual parts.
And then I want to just go back to that screen.
Oh, sure, yeah.
You also had, in addition to your crafting inventory and your cores and your description, we also can see your active quests along the bottom when we don't have any active now.
Correct. If I were to go to objectives, it will tell me what my current quest is. Homeward Bound, the power source, turned out to be a mysterious multicolored disco core, unlike any Jewel had seen before. Jewel hopes this core will restore power to her crawler so she can repair Mac and download any Far Eden mission updates from Earth.
Yep.
This is pretty cool. It can actually track a blueprint.
Okay.
So if I'm actively searching for parts for a particular, crafting materials, I can actually track it. It'll help me find them in the world.
Yep.
And there are, we haven't really talked about this before, but hunting challenges too. So another fun thing to go and sort of grind and explore in these open worlds. I don't think I currently have any blueprints.
Nope.
No, nothing yet.
And how do you find that you've just come across them in the world?
Come across them in the world, yep. They are hidden around. I happen to know that there is a treasure chest up on top of this little rocky pillar there.
We're
going
to go here or we're going to go there?
So we're going to go over here.
Actually, you know what? We're going to stop for a second. Let's stop and ask the chat room on Beam, since it's pretty quick.
Yeah.
You guys want us to go, which is this one over here on the left?
So this one, we can go to pillar on the left, or we can go to pillar on the right. I will tell the chat room, however, we can't actually crawl up to the top of pillar on the right because we don't have a spider frame, so it might be better to go to this one.
Yeah, so which one should we go, right or left?
Go where Joe wants to go.
Go where Joe. Everyone says left, so.
All right. At this point, I want to go on a long beach vacation, but we're not going to do that
today.
Okay, but you can see here I can pop open boxes. I'm going to get that little thing I picked up.
Yep.
It happened pretty fast, but it was an extra one-time lethal attack for Mac.
We can see it because it's filled in.
Yep, so from boxes you can find things like that. Sorry, supply crates,
yes.
Provisioning caches, another piece of loot. A little loot trail, a little breadcrumb trail, lead me up the rocky pillar.
Going up on top here.
Going up on top.
All right, so here we are.
So here we are, this little rocky formation.
It's mysterious.
It is mysterious. It is not natural.
Hmm.
But I will learn later in the game that I can come back to these things with the ape frame, the big sort of strongest of the frames. And the ape's out of combat ability is to smash things.
Now, is he green?
No, he's not green. He's not green, though. We don't have a primary colored core. There is no green-friendly core in the game, so far, at least.
So far,
But if I were to take my beast and smash this rock, I know, having done this before, that I would find one of those prismatic cores hidden underneath there.
Good to know. Kind of like a Kinder Egg.
Kind of like a Kinder Egg. You know, those are contraband, by the way.
Yes, I know.
You're not allowed to bring them into the States.
At least in the United States.
It's like bringing Sudafed into Japan. You just don't do that, Larry.
Just remember.
Come on, you're a world traveler. Oh, hey. Ooh.
Okay.
So here
is
something else. This is a audio log.
Oh. Sorry. Can we play this back?
Sure, let's let people listen to it. Why not?
I've been preparing for your launch a long time. But when your ship finally left Earth.
Hopefully they can hear it okay.
Well, I haven't cried that hard since your mother died.
You guys can hear
I know that. I can't talk to you directly.
Sam. Now I'm going to talk over it, so people can't really hear this until they play the game. But this is an audio log from Jewel's father, Dr. Thomas Adams. The voice that you hear is the narrator in the game.
Okay.
Is her father, And he, through means that you learn later in the game, he and other characters have left these audio logs scattered around. So, again, the reward for exploration, sometimes you get cool upgrades to your core bots, sometimes you get a little bit deeper glimpse into the story, but these audio logs are scattered around the world, so they're a fun thing to find.
So they'll help you fill out what's the mystery of what's going on here.
Indeed, the mystery of what's going on. Okay, so I can see, let's go a little bit. Whoa, that's a big drop.
Yeah, I was going to say, watch yourself
there. Yeah, don't want to fall into the pit.
More rogue core bots. Don't let him near the crawler.
All right, a couple more core bots. We'll use Max.
Boom, look at him go.
He's got three lined up, so we're just going to use all of them.
Bang, bang, bang.
Build up our combo meter here, see if I can earn an instant extract. Come on there, buddy. One down. I don't know if I'll be able to get up to 10 on these guys. That's
yeah, you can. Come on, Joe.
Come on, Mac. Almost. Nope, he's going to die.
All right.
But you can see. So as a player, I have a fundamental choice when I fight enemies in ReCore. Do I want their cores? Do I want to extract their cores? Do I want to build up my own cores? Or do I want to break them, blow them up into parts?
Right.
For crafting. The frame parts for my own core bots.
Right.
You can't do both. If you pull out the core, you don't get any material.
There's
loot.
No loot.
If
right.
you destroy them completely, you don't get their core.
So it's a risk versus reward.
Yes, yes. You got to sort of figure out which one you want to do. Okay.
Okay.
So let's go over here a little bit. I just wanted to show people this view of a dungeon over there. Up on top of this bluff is a dungeon. If you get over there, you will find that this dungeon, in fact, has the highest disco ball core requirement in the game. To unlock these dungeons, you need to have a certain number of cores.
Right.
And I think this one has some insane requirement like 45 or 50.
Okay.
To get into this particular dungeon, you will have needed to find a lot of
wow.
a lot of these cores.
This is right here on the first one of the first
That's
areas.
Right. Meant to tease you, tantalize you. Bring
so
you
now
back.
What's interesting is I noticed that the design decision was made. We've got certainly the health and the ammo, but we don't have a mini map.
We do not have a mini map. That's right. Yep. And, you know, I think a lot of that is just, there's not a lot of the sort of quest density in the world with
sure.
NPCs or other things that you would really want from a
right.
from a mini-map.
Level up. Ooh, nice.
Level up. Yep.
Nice job.
Oh, so Jewel just leveled up. Right, so now Jewel's weapon is a little bit more powerful.
And can we see in the, after this combat, if we can go see in the...
yeah, absolutely.
Skill tree, what's going on.
Yep. And the enemies in this area are a little simpler, you know, just because people will just be starting out the game.
Yeah.
But pretty quick, it'll ramp up for sure. If people saw any of the streams or recording from Gamescom of the Core Foundry demo, you can see how frenetic these things get.
Yes.
All right. So you wanted to see what happened.
So we
to
leveled
Jewel.
Up. So what does that mean?
Right. Okay. So let's go to Jewel.
Okay.
All right, her rifle is now level 3. I don't know what the numbers were before,
okay.
but they have most likely gone up in terms of weapon power. You can see here that Max, I remember his energy was maybe in the 30s before,
right.
potentially. Now that he's level 3, his energy has gone up pretty significantly.
So he levels, let's be clear, he levels up with the main character? Together?
Well, they're sort of joined at the hip now just because they're, you know, he's the only core bot on the field and
sure.
he's basically getting the same sort of XP as you are.
Right.
Once you get two core bots on your party and
right.
you're swapping them in and out,
right.
then it won't feel so docked
so
together.
One, yeah.
Exactly. Every time Mac levels up, he gets a little boost to all of his stats.
Okay.
But to truly achieve his maximum stat potential, his level cap, if you were,
yep.
you have to use Core Fusion. That's
yep.
the only way you're going to get to that level cap
yep.
number. So that's really what Core Fusion is for.
Yep. Okay.
All right. So I'll show you here. I think we've killed all the enemies in this area, or most of them anyways. Jewel's Sandcrawler.
Now, this is where we started the game.
This is where you, yes, in the backstory where Jewel came from.
Right.
Her Sandcrawler looks pretty beaten up,
yeah.
clearly hasn't moved in a couple hundred years. And she's trying to get the power back on. So if I wanted to, I could go back in and press this button and go into the Sandcrawler. And,
are we going to do that?
I don't know. Depends
Should
on
we?
How much time we have.
Should we?
I don't know. I think we might want to leave that because that gets into spoiler story
okay,
territory.
Okay, then we're not doing that.
We probably won't do
nope,
that.
No,
That might be one bridge too far.
We're not going into the crawler today, gang.
That's right. So here you see, though, Larry, this
yes.
Spider rail.
Yeah, oh.
Now, this is something I might see, again, sort of classic Mega Man style.
Yeah.
A thing in the world that you see, you can even sort of platform up here
yeah,
and try to interact
there.
With. Let's see what...
I'm intrigued, Joe.
Yes, as well you should be. I'll get this loot. If I go up to this, I can't really do anything with it right now. You know, I can't, can't interact with it.
Yeah.
But later on, if I were to return with a spider frame, his out-of-combat ability is climbing those rails. Right, so I'd be able to go up there. I know there's a treasure chest with some blueprints, probably another prismatic core, etc. And I'll show you one more thing over here. Now we're going deeper into the demo than I thought we could.
Yeah, we're now in uncharted territory.
You're a smooth talker, Larry.
Well, all of a sudden, here you are.
All right. All right, so another thing to show you. Hey, look at this tantalizing steam vent.
What could that be?
Well, later on in the game,
you, I wish to jump
you might,
on that.
Yeah, you might not want to do that, though. It might hurt you.
Oh, ouch, yeah.
Ouch, don't go there. Later on in the game, you will find another frame that we've talked about, this flyer frame. Now, the flyer frame is able to jump onto these steam vents and glide, and that's how you get up to this 40 or 45 core, I forget how many core, dungeon it
the
is
dungeon
upper,
up there,
up,
right.
over there.
Right.
So you can see, just even in this little first intro area, there are good reasons to backtrack with your spider frame once you get him, with your flyer frame once you get him to that dungeon entrance over there, and there's actually another beast block that you can come back with your ape frame and gather that, break that apart and see what's hidden in there too. I'll show you one more thing over here.
Yes.
This is kind of interesting.
Just looking at the chat room here to see what, you guys are saying. Looks like a lot of people are very excited about it coming out next week.
Okay, good. Yes, I'm excited too. I think this game, I think hopefully is going to surprise a lot of people with how deep it is and how much gameplay there is and how much like real good value you get for your $40. I mean, new IP is hard. It's hard to take a chance on it, I think, as a person who plays games.
Yep.
So I hope people will jump in, and I think they'll be really pleasantly surprised.
Are we underleveled for these guys?
We are indeed, Larry, underleveled for these spiky guys. They overlevel us by some obscene amount and would destroy me quite quickly. But perhaps they're guarding something worth coming back
they're
to
not
later
there.
There.
For, yeah, yep. They're there for a reason.
Yep, absolutely. All right, Mac, let's get out of here. They look too
run
tough.
Run away!
So it's kind of got this classic, RPG-ish, semi-open world feel to it. I think, people who play a game like Destiny are familiar with going into poking your nose into places in the world where maybe you shouldn't go right away and getting your butt handed to you by some overleveled guys and... But it's that same sort of lure and appeal of coming back there later and smashing them and seeing what they were guarding. So that, I think
we're going to stop now.
Maybe let's stop now. I think we'd just get into trouble if we went any further.
Yeah, we don't want to, no spoilers, and this is a good kind of introduction. I mean, clearly it's the beginning of the game to let folks who are watching the stream get ready for it next week.
Yep, absolutely.
There's a lot to explore.
Oh, no, the back end will take
it. Okay, we'll do this while I'm taking us out.
Yeah, he's level 3, so if I'd come this way earlier, he might have been a little bit more tough, but now Mac and I are able to take him down pretty handily. Again, if you end up one-on-one with a Corbot and you're the same level, you're gonna take him down pretty fast.
You know what's actually really interesting, I was just reminded, is so if people are watching us on the stream, they see all these beautiful graphics around us,
Oh, right.
Not included.
No, not the
included.
Faces. Not
everything
the faces.
Else is included. We're actually going to, the ReCore team is releasing those to the community tomorrow so you can get ready for your own streams next week.
That's right, yep.
So we'll be releasing those. Keep an eye on the ReCore community. They'll give you details on how to get all of these graphical assets, and you can do a stream just like this, Joe not included.
Yes.
And we'll have a little bit of fun. So, all right.
Well, I'm going to go up here to this nice vista, and we can hang out there. And I don't know if you want to answer any other questions.
Yeah, we'll take a look at the chat room if you guys have any questions that we can answer.
Let's look at something pretty, though,
shall we? We're going to go up here just to give you some eye candy to take a peek at whilst...
All right, there we go.
That's beautiful. So we've got the chat room up here. If you guys have any questions, let us know. Joe's reading them.
Oh, wait, apparently you are included, Larry. So that's sort of a gift. That's a gift with purchase.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't know that.
That's nice.
They were asking about customization. We saw a little bit of the management screen. Is there any customization?
Yeah, so great question. When it comes to Jewel, her primary customization is her energy rifle.
Yep.
You're getting these ammo types over time. But, Inafune-san and the design team at Armature, Mark Pacini, the game director, really wanted to put most of the customization on your core bots. Because they're the real fun and charm and personality of the game. So, really, I think if people have seen any of the screenshots coming out of Gamescom, you can not only make Mac look significantly different by bolting on different frame parts, but you can really change the way that he behaves in combat. If you want, you can take the blue core Mac and put him into the spider frame. You can take Duncan, the red core, put him into the canine frame, and really change the way that these characters perform in combat. But I mean, they're just such charming, just beautifully designed characters. We wanted to put all the customization on them.
Yeah. So it's also important to point out there's the regular version. There's also a special. I just got my notes here in front of me. There's a the limited edition collector's edition. It's $179.99, and it features a hand finished and hand painted statues of Jewel and Mac.
Yep, absolutely.
Apparently that is for the most authentic representation.
Indeed, and actually someone just asked or pointed out that the collector's edition actually comes with a decoder ring. So if you wanted to speed up your translation of the Digimon language, yes, the decoder ring is quite handy.
We realize that by the end of next week somebody will probably have built a website that has decoded.
That's true. Why are you dissuading people from
I'm saying it's gorgeous. It's beautiful.
Yes. Just,
you know the internet.
That's right. As a matter of fact, I think it'll be like 48 hours before people have it all translated. But that'll be fun. Again, just another cool thing to do. Showing off the depth of the game.
All right. Well, listen, John, we're going to wrap things up here.
Okay.
I know everybody needs to get on with their day. I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Joe Staten, creative director. Is that the term we use?
Well, yeah. You know, for this game, I'm just the lowly writer. Let's run with that.
Yeah, you have an amazing team that you've worked with. Let's give them a shout out.
Absolutely. Again, Keiji Inafune's team at Comcept, incredible group of folks. Armature down in Austin are great, terrific, doing all really the most of the heavy lifting for this game. But we also had really great support from other partners too. Asobo Studio in France. Did just really tremendous work on the dungeons and some of the core bytes and other things as well. Goldtooth, Cinematic House up in Vancouver for all the PerfCap cinematics and other folks too. So this really is a game that publishing saw early, had a lot of potential, and we decided to invest in the game and make it big and a lot of fun. So I hope people give it a shot. You know, I play it every day, and I still have a great time with it.
Just a reminder, it's available next week on Xbox for PC and console. It's a Play Anywhere title, so that means if you buy the Xbox version, you'll get the PC version at no additional charge, or if you buy the PC version on Windows 10, you will get the Xbox version at no additional charge, and it supports cross-game saves, so you'll be able to take your save with you.
Absolutely.
So check that out. You can pre-order it now if you'd like. Swing by my blog at majornelson.com. You can follow Joe on Twitter. Joe, how do they find you?
I am the at Joe Staten.
Okay, and I am the at Major Nelson. So
man, I need a name with like a military rank on it. what I need.
I'm
really
sure
set
you can
off.
Come up with something. Anyway,
Buck Private Joe, something. We'll talk later. Buck you give Private me some Joe. Tips.
All right, gang. Thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you for tuning in on Twitch. Thank you for tuning in on Beam. My name's Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson, here with the incredible Joe Staten, reminding you that adventure starts in the core. We'll see you next time. Bye bye, everybody.
Bye. Thanks.
Dear Jewel, I left you with a few things to always hold on to. Loyalty, elusiveness, and brute force. If you remember these lessons, you will survive. If anyone can, it's you. Love you always. Dad.